Good day, and welcome to Hiroshima University's English Podcast.
Hi everyone, I'm Kay.
And I'm Joe.
And today we're talking about a very delicious topic. We're talking about...
coffee!
Yay!
Right, coffee. It's very delicious, especially, and it wakes you up too.
Yeah, right. Do you like coffee?
Yes, I love coffee. Every morning I drink about 2 cups.
Oh, really?
Especially in the morning, but I don't drink any more later in the day. How about you, Kay? Do you like coffee?
Yeah, I like coffee, especially when I'm in laboratory, especially when I'm working with my computer.
Okay, good, good.
Like, when is the first time you ever drunk coffee?
In college.
Right? Oh, really? Really?
That's right. In high school, it didn't taste good. It didn't taste good, no. But in college, I needed to stay awake.
Right.
Especially I had part-time jobs and things like that, so I drank coffee in college. How about you? When's the first time you drank coffee?
I think when I was in kindergarten.
Wow!
Like it was an accident, I guess. Like, my father was drinking, and, like, I thought it looked kind of delicious for me. Because, you know, 親が飲んでるものは美味しそうに見えるから。Yeah.
Okay.
And what kind of coffee do you like?
My favorite is Starbucks Guatemala coffee.
Ah, Starbucks, 確かに美味しい美味しい。
Guatemala, so I bring it home because if you buy it there, it's too expensive.
Right.
Make it from the grains, then I can do it in my house. How about you? What kind of coffee do you like?
I like decaf recently.
Okay.
Decaf coffee. Decaf のコーヒー最近好きですね。
Very good. Yeah. Let's talk some more about coffee.
皆さんこんにちは。今日は美味しいテーマ、コーヒーについてお話しします。コーヒーにはたくさん種類があるんですけど、有名なのはカプチーノ、エスプレッソ、ブラック、モカ、あとラテなんかがあると思うんですけど、この5つの違いを皆さん英語で説明することできるでしょうか？私はできないんですけど。
Most people don't know the difference.
日本語でも無理だと思う。
They're very famous, right? Cappuccino, espresso, black coffee, mocha, latte.But what are they actually?
Yeah, what are they? I cannot really understand that,
That's
even
right.
in Japanese.
That's right.
なので、ジョーがこれから英語でこのうちの4つを1つずつ説明するので、皆さんは一体どの種類について説明されているのか、ちょっと想像してみてください。
Okay, this is kind of a game, everyone. So there's 5 choices again. Do you remember? Cappuccino, espresso, black, mocha, and latte.And the first one here is very easy.
Okay.
This is coffee with no milk or cream in it.
Okay.
Can you guess, everybody? Coffee with no milk or cream in it.
I think I got it.
Everyone, you got it? The answer is?
It's black.
That's right. Black coffee is, it's also called regular coffee.
Okay.
And often instant is this, it can be instant coffee, right? And this black coffee first came from like Yemen, which is in the Middle East, right? That's where the drink began. And the plant began in Ethiopia in Africa, right? About 500 years ago.And today, of course, a lot of countries, for example, Kenya, Colombia, Brazil, they all make very good coffee, right? Okay, everyone, we've got 4 choices left here. Can you get the second one here? Okay, this one here is a mixture of coffee and chocolate. What do you think? A mixture of coffee and chocolate. And again, the 4 choices are cappuccino, espresso, mocha, and latte.What do you think? A mixture of coffee and chocolate? Even get your answer out there?
Does that exist?
The answer is...
The answer is mocha.
That's right. So if you like a sweeter coffee with a little bit of chocolate in it, you want mocha, right? Mocha also began in Yemen.
Yes.
And it's a dark brown color. Dark brown color, of course, right?
真っ黒じゃないんですね。
Okay, everyone. Our third coffee here. And we've got 3 choices left.Cappuccino, espresso, and latte. What is it? 3 choices, everybody. This is a very strong coffee.
Yes.
It comes in a small amount. If you drink it, it'll wake you up. It's a strong coffee.
超ちっちゃいカップで来るっていうのがポイントです。
Everyone, you got your answer out there? The answer is...
Espresso.
That's right. Espresso is a very strong coffee. It has no milk in it. It first began in Italy, right? And it's made by forcing hot water through crushed coffee beans. Right. So, of course, you need a machine to make this, right? Okay. We've got one more left on our quiz here, everybody. And there's 2 choices, right? Latte and cappuccino. What do you think I'm gonna, it is here? Okay, everyone got it? This coffee has a lot of hot steamed milk in it.
Milk. Okay, okay.
So the key word here is milk.
That's
right. It's very milky taste. Lots of milk in it. What do you think? Is it the cappuccino or is it the latte? It is...
It's latte.
That's right. The word latte in Italian means milk.
あ、そうなの?
Yes, yes, yes.
I didn't know that.
Right, so a very milky taste. It's from Italy originally, right? And cappuccino, the final one here, that's also got some steamed milk foam in it, but not as much, not so much.
あ、OK.
Right.
じゃあミルクがより多いのはラテってことですね。
That's right.
皆さんは正解できましたかね?今日のダイアログは今日からバリスタになりますっていう女の子がコーヒーのテイスティングをするっていうお話なんですけど、まずはゆっくりなスピードで聞いてみましょう。
Welcome to your new job as a barista, Sarah.
Thanks. I'm really excited to become a first class barista.
Good to hear. Okay.In order to brew a delicious cup of coffee, you need to be able to distinguish good coffee from bad coffee. So, let's start there.
Okay, I'm ready. I actually already did some studying about different types of coffee beans, so I'm confidentthat I'll be able to tell the types of coffee just by having a sip.
That's great, Sarah. Now, there are 4 coffee cups in front of you. They're brewed with different coffee beans. The coffee beans were grown in Brazil, Kenya, Guatemala,and Ethiopia. Just tell me what kind of taste difference there is, and I'll guide you to the answer.
I don't know. I can't tell the difference.
Okay, that's fine. How did the first cup taste?Did it have a strong, sweet flavor to it? Or did it have a strong, toasted flavor?
The first cup tasted bitter.
Okay, okay. Then try to remember the taste and move on to the second cup and compare how they taste. How was the second cup compared to the first?
They're both bitter.
Okay. This time, let's try the third cup. Try to close your eyes and just focus on the taste. Doesn't it taste a little fruity compared to the other two?
Yeah.You're right. It tastes a little fruity. Wait a minute. No, it just tastes bitter. Are you tricking me? They all taste the same. There's no difference.
It looks like it's going to take you a long time to become a barista.
やっぱりコーヒー豆っていうのはすごい繊細な味がするので、私たち素人では区別が難しいんですね。ちょっとね。
That's right. It takes a long time to learn about coffee and to distinguish between the different types of coffee.
今日はまず最初に、サラ、君も今日からバリスタだねっていうふうに男の人が言ってあげてます。A barista でバリスタという意味ですね。
Right. It's a person who is really good at making coffee. You can say as a joke to your father, oh, you are like a barista.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right.
スタバにいる人ですね。 で、美味しいコーヒーを入れるには、いい豆と悪い豆の区別をつけないといけないよっていうふうに言ってあげてます。to brew で、このコーヒーの場合では、コーヒーを入れるっていう意味ですけど、お酒とかだと醸造するという意味にもなります。
That's right. So you can brew coffee, you can brew sake,、mm-hmm. and you also brew beer. That company brews a lot of beer, or they brew a lot of sake in Saijo, 東Hiroshima.
そして to distinguish 何か from 何かっていうので何々を区別するという意味ですね。
Right, and in the dialogue, the man says that the woman needs to be able to distinguish good coffee from bad coffee. To distinguish good coffee from bad coffee.
Yeah, which is really difficult.
That's right. Kate, can you distinguish good fish?From so-so fish, expensive maguro, which is like tuna, expensive tuna from regular tuna. Can you distinguish them?
No, I don't think I can distinguish
them. Actually, I cannot either. But a lot of Japanese, I think, can really distinguish good fish from so-so fish.
Yeah, yeah, so-so fish.
That's right.
Yeah, I gotta learn that from my mom. で、女の子は実はバリスタになるからちょっと勉強したんですっていうふうに言ってます。だからちょっと飲んだらコーヒーのタイプがわかると思うっていうふうに言ってます。To have a sip でちょっと飲むっていう意味ですね。
That's right. For example, I had a sip of that drink, but I didn't really like it, for example.
で、ここから4種類の豆のテイスティングをしていくことになりました。でも女の子は、ちょっと味の違いがわかんないっていうふうに言ってます。なので男の人は最初の1個目から順番に味を見ていこうっていうふうに言っています。で、最初の、カップはどんな味だったかっていうふうに男の人がまず順繰りに教えてってあげてますね。で、なんかこう、よく熱を込めていられたような味がしなかったっていうふうに言ってます。Toasted っているという意味ですね。
Yeah, so it's kind of that flavor or that taste of toast.Right?
Yes.
So a coffee can sometimes taste a bit like toast, right?
Right. 焼かれたような感じの味ですね。
Right. So this coffee has a strong toasted flavor, like that.
そこから2杯目、3杯目と飲んでいくんですが、女の子はただただ苦いってことしかわからないんですね。だからここでアドバイスとして男の人が、じゃあ目を閉じて味だけに集中してごらんっていうふうに言ってます。So how do you say, 集中する in English?
Right, to focus on something.
To focus on something. Right. 集中するということですね。
Right, for example, you should focus on your studies. Or in the report here, you should focus on this section and improve it like that. And in the dialogue, the man says that she should close her eyes and just focus on the taste.
で、まあ目を閉じて飲んでみたんですけど、4杯目を飲んでもやっぱり同じ味がする。もう苦いばっかり。あなた私をからかってるの?っていうふうに怒っています。ここが最後の面白い表現です。To trick でからかうという意味ですね。
Right. She thinks that he is tricking him.Right, because she thinks there's no difference in the taste, right?
Yeah, poor him.
Right.
かわいそう。
Yes, he needs a teacher more.
Yeah.
And with that, let's listen at natural speed, and we'll talk a little bit more about coffee at the end.
Okay.
Welcome to your new job as a barista, Sarah.
Thanks.I'm really excited to become a first-class barista.
Good to hear. Okay, in order to brew a delicious cup of coffee, you need to be able to distinguish good coffee from bad coffee. So, let's start there.
Okay, I'm ready. I actually already did some studying about different types of coffee beans.So I'm confident that I'll be able to tell the types of coffee just by having a sip.
That's great, Sarah. Now, there are four coffee cups in front of you. They're brewed with different coffee beans. The coffee beans were grown in Brazil, Kenya, Guatemala, and Ethiopia. Just tell me what kind of taste difference there is, and I'll guide you to the answer.
I don't know. I can't tell the difference.
Okay, that's fine. How did the first cup taste? Did it have a strong sweet flavor to it? Or did it have a strong toasted flavor?
Well, the first cup tasted bitter.
Okay. Then try to remember the taste and move on to the second cup and compare how they taste. How was the second cup compared to the first?
They're both bitter.
Okay. This time, let's try the third cup. Try to close your eyes and just focus on the taste. Doesn't it taste a little fruity compared to the other two?
Yeah, you're right. It tastes a little fruity. Wait a minute. No, it just tastes bitter. Are you tricking me? They all taste the same. There's no difference.
Ah, it looks like it's going to take you a long time to become a barista.
Hey everyone, today we talked about coffee, but actually, coffee shops are great places to meet foreigners.
Yes, right.
If you go to Starbucks or some other big famous shop, there's lots of foreigners there, right?
Yes.
Go there and without reserve, without hesitation, try to speak to that foreigner who is right near you. If you do, that the foreigner is probably a tourist, you can have a very good conversation
in a coffee shop
and try to learn the names of the coffees
too. It costs only like 300 yen.
And we'll see you next time at Hiroshima University's English Podcast. Bye.
Bye-bye.